Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to look at aromatic versus anti-aromatic and non-aromatic. In the previous videos, we looked at the conditions for aromaticity and determined that for a molecule to be aromatic, it has to be cyclic, planar, conjugated, and obey Huckel's rule with a shortcut that we've identified as 4n plus 2 equals pi electrons means they need to have an odd number of electron pairs. What happens to a molecule that doesn't follow these rules and is not considered aromatic? There are two different classes of molecules that you have to be able to recognize. The first is anti-aromatic, and the second is non-aromatic. I have seen many students master aromaticity, but when a molecule is not aromatic, confuse these two and lose points on their exam. So what's the difference between them? How do we tell if it's anti-aromatic or non-aromatic? This depends on the individual situation. Let's sidetrack from aromaticity and talk about baseball for a second. There are three types of New Yorkers. There are Mets fans, like myself. There are Yankee fans, like some of my unfortunate friends. Mets fans, we don't just want the Mets to win, we also want the Yankees to lose. Yankee fans, who don't just want the Yankees to win, they want the Mets to lose. And then there are people like my sister who can't tell a foul ball from a home run, even if she's sitting right by the foul pole. Back to the baseball rivalry. It's not enough for that thing that's important to you to win. You also want anyone who doesn't exactly agree with you to lose. You're too close. It's not enough to be one or nothing. But people who don't care, they don't care. If you find a hardcore baseball fan, everything about them will be very similar. They watch baseball games. They know their players. They know their pitchers. They know their stats. They tend to wear the same type of baseball gear, except that one specific detail will be different. It'll be the New York Mets logo or the New York Yankees logo. They're very similar to each other. An outsider might not be able to recognize them, but they are definitely very different. What does this have to do with aromaticity? Look at the first three criteria. If you quickly glance at a molecule, you can tell if it's cyclic, planar, or conjugated. Just like a baseball fan, you can typically tell if somebody supports baseball or not based on what they're wearing or the fact that they show up to a game. The thing that makes them different and is slightly harder to understand is Huckel's rule. Think of odd or even as two different baseball teams. There's team odd, which follows Huckel's rule, that gives us aromatic. There's team even, that does not follow Huckel's rule. Everything else about it is the same, but because the number of electrons is different, because the energy of the molecule is so high as a result, it's exactly the opposite, and there is rivalry between the odd and the even, between Huckel's rule and non-Huckel's rule. So we can say that molecules that are not aromatic, despite everything else being the same, they are anti-aromatic. They don't want team aromaticity to win. But then, if you have someone who doesn't care about baseball, doesn't care about aromaticity whatsoever, meaning they don't follow the first three obvious criteria, then those are considered non-aromatic. Let's bring this to life with a few examples. Say we have a molecule that looks like this. It looks very much like benzene. It's got 6 carbons, 3 pi bonds, resonating system. Is it aromatic or not? Let's go backwards on this, but skipping Huckel's rule, because this is one you only want to check if the first three criteria are met. Because if not, it doesn't matter if it obeys Huckel's rule or not. Is the molecule conjugated? Absolutely. We have 3 pi bonds that can resonate over the entire system back and forth. Is it planar? Yes. Every carbon has a pi bond, it's sp2 hybridized, and that makes it flat. But is it cyclic? No, it's not, because carbon 1 is not attached to carbon 6, and that means this is an aliphatic or linear molecule rather than a cyclic compound. This molecule doesn't care about baseball. It's a linear compound. It has nothing to do with aromaticity, and so it is non-aromatic. This next example looks a little scary at first, Don't let the positive charge scare you. Follow the checklist as you would with anything else. Is the molecule cyclic? Well, yes, it is. It's a hexagon just like benzene. Is the molecule planar? That's a good question. Typically, if the molecule is all carbon, we look to see if they're sp2 hybridized as our shortcut. And in this case, we have four obvious sp2. But what about the other two carbons? The carbon with a carbocation is sp2 hybridized. Carbocations like this are sp2 hybrids because carbon is bound to two carbons, one hydrogen, and it has an empty p orbital. That's where that positive charge sits. The carbocation is a deficiency with an empty p orbital. That makes this carbon sp2. But this last one down here does not have a charge. Not having a charge and not having a pi bond tells us that it's got to have a second hydrogen. Two bonds to carbon, two bonds to hydrogen tells us it's sp3 hybridized, which is tetrahedral. This is a 3D carbon, not flat, three-dimensional, making the molecule not planar. The second you figure out it's not planar, you can say, doesn't care about baseball, not an aromatic compound, non-aromatic. But if you weren't sure, you can continue. You don't have to, we already have the answer, but just in case. Is this molecule conjugated? Technically, yes. We can have resonance between the pi bonds and into that carbocation's MTP orbital, but the resonance does not carry through the entire ring, making this a non-fully conjugated. For aromaticity, it's got to be fully conjugated around the entire ring. Once again, not a baseball fan, non-aromatic, and we're done. We don't even have to look at Huckel's rule. Huckel's rule only applies if the first three criteria are met. Here's a fun, tricky one that professors love to put on exams, and many students get this wrong. Is the molecule cyclic? Why, yes, it is. I can trace a path from the first to last carbon. Is this molecule planar? It appears to be so. All carbons are pi bound. Is this molecule conjugated? All the carbons have a pi bond. That means they all appear to have the ability to resonate throughout the entire system. Yes, it appears conjugated. And if we use the trick for Huckel's rule, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pi bonds, which is an odd number. That means it's team Huckel's rule or team aromaticity. It appears to be aromatic, except for one tiny, tiny little detail. And that is what's going on right here. In addition to what we see, there is also an invisible hydrogen on every carbon atom. When carbon is sp2 hybridized, the ideal bond angle is 120 degrees, and that means for nearly every carbon, the hydrogen atom is facing out. No big deal, except for these two. At 120 degrees, the hydrogen should be over here, and the other hydrogen should be over here. They appear to want to occupy the same space, which is impossible. Remember that atoms have their personal space, and if two atoms get too close together, it's going to cause strain in the molecule. The two sides of the molecule are going to push each other away, just like if you were talking to someone and they invaded your personal space, your instinct would be to want to push them away so you can have a little bit of breathing room. The way this happens in the molecule is that one of the carbon atoms gets pushed slightly up, so the hydrogen points upward. The other one gets pushed slightly down, so that the hydrogen points downward, which suddenly means the molecule is no longer planar. So even though it appears to follow all, this molecule is considered non-aromatic. It's a pretend baseball fan, but it really doesn't care about baseball. You can build this with a model kit, but to help you visualize, I want you to imagine that this carbon atom is light blue, this carbon atom is green, and the rest of the ring is blue. If we show the ring from the side, we'll have these four carbon atoms, like so, and these four carbon atoms would be directly on top of them because from a side view, this molecule is trying to be flat, with the bonds looking like that. Now the light blue carbon atom we said got pushed down, the green carbon atom got pushed up, and this allows their hydrogens to face in a different direction. But look at that. The molecule is not flat. It doesn't sit in one plane because these two carbons are out of the plane, one above and one below. Let's go back to cyclobutadiene, which we've seen in the last video, and run through the checklist again. Yes, the molecule is cyclic. Yes, it's planar, all sp2 carbon atoms, two pi bonds. Yes, it's conjugated. We've already seen that it can resonate up and down around the ring. But now let's look at Huckel's rule from the perspective of a fan or an anti-fan. We have four pi electrons, which is two pi bonds. An even number of electron pairs gives us a fan of the opposite team, of the anti-team, making the structure anti-aromatic. Now what happens with ions? Molecules that look aromatic but have a plus or minus charge, or heterocyclic compounds that have something other than carbon in the ring, like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, and so on. How do we determine if they are aromatic, anti-aromatic, or non-aromatic? That's exactly what we'll cover in the next video. For even more on this topic, including the common aromatic compounds cheat sheet and aromaticity practice quiz, first, give this video a thumbs up, then visit my website, layforsci.com/aromaticity.